ex-employees of a locally based vegan food company are speaking out, saying their employer laid off the entire production crew.
No Evil Foods provided a statement to Business Insider confirming they've laid off their entire production crew and are moving from in-house manufacturing to co-packing manufacturer. Company officials say this decision would help them survive by allowing them to focus on marketing and sales without the challenges of being a small sole manufacturer.
It was absolutely shocking because we'd went through COVID, you know, with them the whole nine yards.
But these two former employees say the layoffs are especially insulting considering they chose to work through the pandemic after the company gave an ultimatum to the production crew to either work through COVID-19 and get a bonus or leave.
I gave everything I had to that company. I carried that company through some very hard times.
Above all, the two wish the company had given them more notice.
I just wish they would have went about it different. Like, hey, we'll give you a 2 weeks head up. Maybe some type of severance. You know, give me a little bit to, you know, to hold me over for the rest of the month.
And as they scramble to figure out what's next for them and their families, they're hoping someone else will give them a chance.
Now, we have reached out to No Evil Foods for comment, but we haven't heard back.
We have spent the past year going after No Evil Foods. They are a vegan, plant-based manufacturer. They have adopted all the left-wing tropes. They have the Zapatista burger. The heads of the company dress like they're leftists. They're called No Evil Foods, but they have venture capital from Blue Horizon. And their workers down in North Carolina wanted to go union, and they violated the National Labor Relations Board, fired one of the people who tried to organize a union and fought the union. Then as the pandemic hit, they told their workers, you have a choice, either work through the pandemic or quit. The people who chose to work through the pandemic, they were told, your family. This is what the No Evil Foods, the two people who run No Evil Foods said, your family, we'll take care of you. The pandemic supposedly came to an end last month, and No Evil Food thanked their workers by announcing with no notice, we're closing up shop, you're all fired, no severance pay, no COBRA, no benefits, go home. We've signed a deal to co-manufacture our plant-based leftist vegan meat somewhere in Chicago. And, you know, we begged the people from No Evil Food to recognize the union. We've asked Sadrah, Schadel, she's one of the CEOs, and Mike Woliansky, he's the other CEO, to donate to the fund for the workers who suddenly found themselves out of a job. They didn't donate. And now I'm getting notes that Sadrah Schadel, the CEO of No Evil Foods, is gaslighting her former employees who have gone, you know, who had to get food stamps. And this is what she wrote to the workers who are going hungry because No Evil Foods fired them all. Sadrah writes, hey, I've seen some of your recent Instagram stories and wanted to connect with you. We're obviously going through a super challenging period at No Evil Foods and had to make a fast and excruciating decision to close our North Carolina production operations. Our team didn't have warning because we didn't have warning. This wasn't a premeditated move. We ran out of money. We were trying to hold on to raise more capital, but our cash reserves kept getting lower and we couldn't support a $500,000 a month burn. So when an anticipated investment of $2 million unexpectedly fell through, we literally had no other option. There was no money to pay severance. And she says she's now only living on $50,000 a year. This is what they're telling the workers. She doesn't tell the workers what percentage of the new $2 million investment she got to bank. So she claims, and let's believe her, she claims that No Evil Foods is going out of business, that the Capitol fell through. Forget karma. Just pure business sense. Would No Evil Foods be in better shape right now if they recognized the union?
Look, of course. Of course. I mean, like I think that this is the thing. Like, remember the very first time we met, David, when our mutual friend brought me onto this show, and I talked about worker-owned cooperatives and economic democracy and what happens whenever you actually genuinely partner with workers in a business enterprise. There are so many examples, and the hard social science data is clear that cooperatives and cooperative decision-making, cooperative businesses last longer. They play their workers better. They are more resilient. In every way, they're better. The problem, as I understand No Evil Foods, is it was a marketing gimmick. The whole Zapatista burger and the Comrade Chuck, that was a bunch of bullshit. They did not actually have real politics behind it. They saw a marketing niche that they were going to exploit because vegans, for the most part, are lefties. And so they were looking for market share. That's the problem with No Evil Foods, and it's the problem when things are just branding and marketing and not actually rooted in anything real. And that's why this neoliberalism, whether it's under the guise of Republicans or Democrats or independents, like, that doesn't matter. What matters is, do we have a political analysis around liberty and justice? Do we have an analysis around ordinary people able to meet our needs? I think No Evil Foods is just another microcosm of everything that's wrong with trying to market socialism. We should actually say we really are socialists. We actually believe from each according to their abilities, to each according to their needs. That's what I think. I don't know about you, Sherry. Am I going too far?
Well, I'm the last person to say you're going too far, but I would definitely, you know, say the other controversial piece, which is, I think that, you know, workers are tired of business unionism, people have a bad taste in their mouth. And that's why, you know, a big thing that the Poor People's Army does, and partly it's because many of us have labor backgrounds. I was very active in the Hormel strike. And we knew that they were going to use unemployed and welfare recipients to cross that picket line. So we set up a food bank immediately so that we could form relationships with Jim Guyette of solidarity, of working together, of understanding everybody's a paycheck or two away from homelessness or a healthcare crisis. Right now, in several of our takeover houses, we have people that are members of the Teamsters that are homeless right now. And to be honest with you, we can't get a whole lot of Teamsters involved in helping us, because they make $125 a week working part-time. So these are, you know, these are different times right now. Never did I dream that we would have so many union leaders calling us saying, can you help this family have some place to live?
Yeah, well, that speaks volumes to how bad our unions are in America. But going back to No Evil Foods, because we've been covering this story for a year, when you say to the workers, you don't need a union and we're going to fire you if you do. When you say we're family, don't sign the union. They block the union. They say you don't need protection. Work through the pandemic or quit. Trust us. People work through the pandemic and No Evil Foods. And then last month they fired them with no notice. You are then untrustworthy. Sadrah, Schadel and Mike Woliansky, the CEOs of No Evil Food, cannot be trusted anymore. So when she then plays the victim, when she direct messages these workers who are now going to food shelters and say, please understand, this was all unexpected. Well, you don't close up shop in North Carolina and move to Chicago unexpectedly. You have that's months in the making. So that's the first lie. And the idea that you're burning through $500,000 a month and you're the victim here and you have a $2 million investment, another $2 million investment that fell through. She doesn't tell the workers her cut of the $2 million, her cut of the $500,000 a month that she's burning through. She just talks about the $50,000 a year she's collecting in salary, not in profits. The way she lies to the workers and plays the victim. And I think she honestly believes her own, I won't say horseshit, I'll say no evil foods. I think she believes her own no evil foods. She actually believes she's the victim. And she's telling the worker she fired, the one she screwed over, you got to understand what I'm going through. That's the pathology of capitalism. And especially people like Sadrah, Schadel and Mike Woliansky, they think they're the victims in all this. And they think I'm cruel, that Jacobin is cruel for reporting about this. They think the unions are cruel for picking on them.